क्रतुं महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाय संप्रक्त वागर्थ प्रतिपत्ते जगतः पितरो वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरो येनाक्षर समाम्नाय मधुरं महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मित्रयं धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्सुबन्ताधिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमामाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीं अवेदां जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं मुक्तिप्रदां शारदां गत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां पुण्यां करोमि पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदीम्। सो वी आर लुकिंग एट त्रिजंत शब्द। We started by the odd sutra, odd in the sense odd word, as to lead to Trijanta Shabda, actually Rukaranta Shabda, not Trijanta Shabda. Rukaranta is an example of Trijanta Shabda or Trinanta, and we started with the Kroshtu Shabda. So Kroshtu, what was the sutra there? Long back, not Khaloku. So we Trijuvat Bhava, we looked at this Kroshtu Shabda, Dhatru Shabda, then Dhata Shabda, then Naptu Ityadiha. We looked at these Shabdas which were covered by Naptru इत्यादि सी अप्त्रन या सो 6411 अप्त्रन त्रिच स्वस्रो नप्त्रो नेष्ट्रो त्वष्ट्रो क्षत्रो होत्रो पोत्रो प्रशास्त्रुणाम। सो देयर बाय वी लैंडेड ऑन दी त्रिजंत शब्द एंड इन दैट नप्त्र शब्द इत्यादि आर स्पेसिफिकली लिस्टेड। सो इफ दे आर स्पेसिफिकली लिस्टेड देन व्हाट विल हैपन इज दैट दे विल बिकम नियमार्थ व्हाट इज ऑलरेडी प्राप्त दीज particular words will show that the rule applies only for these words, meaning Trijanta and Trinanta words, and not the other Trich or Trinanta Shabdas which are covered by the Unadi Sutra. So there are some Unadi Sutras also which is given. Those who are interested can look up in just a moment, my pen is not working. Let me replug and see.
हाँ बोलो।
इट्स वर्किंग नाउ। ओके, सो हियर यू लुक एट दिस शब्द, सॉरी सम बैकग्राउंड नॉइस। ओके, लेट मी जस्ट म्यूट कल्याण जी। ओके, सो अप्तरुण इत्यादि, सो दोज हू आर इंटरेस्टेड कैन रीड दिस दीज टू। एज टू अष्टाध्यायी सूत्र गिव्स Trich Pratyaya and then Trin Pratyaya by various Nul Trichau and Trin Sutras. Then there are Unadi Sutras which give Trich and Trinanta. So if these Naptru Ityadi are mentioned here, Aptru Ityadi, then these words show, this Sutra shows that Trijanta and Trinanta, meaning Rukar ending words, had already some rules which were mentioned. Dirgha. So these ordain something, but why particular sutra gata shabdas have been used, some words within the sutra which are rukaranta. So rukaranta is covered by Trijanta and Trinanta, rules made for those. However, this particular Trijanta shabda, rukaranta shabda, show that these are exceptions where a particular rule which was followed will apply, whatever is ordained there, and it will not apply to other words which have this Trich or Trin Pratyaya in their ending. Meaning Unadi Sutra covered Trinanta or Trijanta Shabda will not have such application. So that is the meaning here, and thereby we land on Pitru Shabda. So Pitru Shabda is not covered there. Then what will happen? तेन इह न पिता, सो पिता शब्द विल नॉट टेक दीर्घ, पिता शब्द इज नॉट कवर्ड देर, देर फोर दीर्घ इज नॉट गोइंग टू अप्लाई टू पिता, पितरु शब्द. सो वॉट विल हैपन वेन यू, पिता विल डिक्लाइन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम धाता और दाता शब्द, धातृ शब्द और दातृ शब्द, दाता दातारो दाता रह इन लघु वी कवर धाता शब्द. सो विल से धाता धातारो धाता रह धातारम धातारौ, देन सर्वनामस्थान इज ओवर इन पुल्लिंग धातृन इत्यादि. अवर फोकस इज द सर्वनामस्थान, वेयर सर्वनामस्थान हैज उपदा दीर्घत्वम और समथिंग एल्स मेंशन्ड देर, दैट विल बी कवर्ड बाय अनदर सूत्र नाउ. सो इन दी फर्स्ट केस सिंगुलर, वेयर एज इन दी धाता शब्द अ पर्टिकुलर रूल अप्लाइड, दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू अप्लाई हियर इन सर्वनामस्थान. सर्वनामस्थाने च असंबुद्धौ नकारस्य उपदायः दीर्घः, नकार उपदः विल टेक दीर्घः बाय सर्वनामस्थान. इट इज मेंशन्ड दैट बाय दिस सूत्र सर्वनामस्थाने च असंबुद्धौ न उपदायः दीर्घः, मीन्स नः नः नकारस्य उपदायः दीर्घः, द उपदा ऑफ नकार एट द एंड ऑफ द शब्द विच हैज कम बाय अन अनंग अनंग सौ. सो पितृ प्लस सु विल अट्रैक्ट दिस रुदशनस पुरुदंसो अनेहसांच अनंग, अनंग इज द आदेश एंड अन पितृ, रु विल टेक अनादेश, इट विल बिकम पितन. सो पितन प्लस सु प्रत्यय, दिस पितन इज नकार एंडिंग नाउ, सो इज नकार एंडिंग हैज एन उपदह अकार विच विल टेक दीर्घ, सो इट विल बिकम दीर्घ बाय सर्वनामस्थाने च असंबुद्धौ नकारस्य उपदायः दीर्घः भवति बाय दिस सूत्र नॉट बाय अप्तृंतृच, दिस सूत्र वोंट अप्लाई हियर अप्तृंतृच इत्यादि. That also ordains dirgha, but it is applicable only for particular listed words, not this pitru shabda ityadi. Thereby, what will happen? The first case singular form is similar to the dhata shabda, dhata similarly pita also, but the upada dirghatvam is due to this sarvanamasthani cha sambuddho, not patrum ityadi. The effect is the same, upada dirgha is attained and then you get pitan, pitan becomes pitan, pitan plus sakara, halnyabhyo, dirghat sutisya pruktam hal, lopaha lupyate, it will go away, sakara goes away, then you have pitan, nakara nalopa pratipadikantasya padasya cha, the padanta nakara which is same as the pratipadikanta nakara, pitru, just because ru is replaced by an does not lose its pratipadika sanya, so nakara will be pratipadika anta nakara and here since pitru plus su, this entire thing is a pada, this is a pada, so padanta and this pitru which is also now pitan, that is also what, that is pratipadika, so pratipadika anta nakara, this nakara is same as the padanta nakara, this nakara, therefore nalop of pratipadika antasya will apply and you will get pita shabda, na will go away and you will get pita. Then what happens in the second case, pita pitru, pitru shabda plus au, su au, just that au, there in dhatru shabda we had got dhatarau, akara by dirghatva by aptrun ityadi, aptrun truch, that had given dirgha. Now that dirgha is not possible by that sutra. So what happens? Pitru plus au, here you will get rutogni sarvanamasthanayoho angasya gunaha. Anga will take guna, ru will become a, then urandrapara will apply and you will get pitar. Pitar plus au, just varnamilana will give pitarau. So not like dhatarau, but pitarau. Therefore, there is a difference in rukaranta. Some decline like dhatru shabda, other decline like pitru shabda. So upada dhirgatva is not there in sarvanamasthana. No, now further what will happen? Pita, pitaro, pitarha, pitaram, pitaro. Earlier in sarvanamasthana we got dirgha, dhata, dhataro, dhataraha, dhataram, dhatarau. First five, sut, sut anapunsakasya sarvanamasthanam. Now this anapunsakasya, so this is not napunsaka pullinga, it will also get sarvanamasthana, sut are all sarvanamasthana. Thereby in all five places here there is no upada dirgha, except for the first case singular where it is by a different sutra. Sarvanamasthane cha asambuddhau न उपधायः दीर्घः नकारस्य उपधायः दीर्घः दैट इज द ओनली केस विच इज इंटरेस्टिंग वेर यू गेट द सेम फॉर्म एज धाता पिता बाय डिफरेंट सूत्र बट इट विल नॉट अप्लाई इन अदर फोर केसेस ऑफ सर्वनाम स्थान देर बाय यू गेट पितरौ पितरः देन पितरम पितरौ इन टिल द्वितीय द्विवचन देन पितरुन इत्यादि ऑल दिस इज सिमिलर एवं जामत्रु आदयः सिमिलरली व्हाट सन इन लॉ शब्द जामत्रु जामत्रु आल्सो विल बी लाइक दैट देन इन दी गीता प्रेस बुक देयर इज अ टिप्पणा विच गोज एज टू पिता माता ननांदा च स्वेष्ट्रु भात्रयातरः जामाता दुहिता देवा त्रिन त्रिभ्याम रहिता नव देर आर नाइन वर्ड्स लिस्टेड विच आर नॉट हैविंग दिस त्रिन और त्रिच प्रत्यय त्रिनंता एंड त्रिजंता दे साउंड लाइक त्रिजंता और त्रिनंता बट दे आर नॉट दे आर रुकारांत शब्दास दे हैव नॉट टेकन त्रिच और त्रिज त्रिन प्रत्यय एज ऑर्डेन्ड बाय अष्टाध्यायी देर मे बी समथिंग एल्स गोइंग ऑन देर विथ उणादि सूत्र बट दे आर नॉट अष्टाध्यायी ऑर्डेन्ड त्रिन और त्रिच शब्दास देर फोर अप्तृन इत्यादि सूत्र वोंट कवर दी दीर्घ उपदा दीर्घ नॉट उपदा दीर्घ दीर्घ और वॉट एवर इज द केस स्पेसिफिकली वेयर दिस सूत्र अप्लाइज इन दी सर्वनाम स्थान दैट विल नॉट अप्लाई एनी मोर द वे इट अप्लाइज इन धातृ शब्द फर्दर वॉट नृ शब्द नृ इज ऑल्सो रुकारांत शब्द सो वॉट हैपन्स विथ दैट शब्द हियर इट इज मेन्शन्ड Just give me one moment. Let me close this WhatsApp, which is irritating. I get some beeps. Okay. So nrushabda. Nrushabda. Nru means a person. Nara has the same meaning as nara. How does it decline? So there rukaranta. It is rukaranta. It is not trujanta. It is not trunanta. But ru is there in the end. So here what happens is that nru plus su. इन फर्स्ट केस सिंगुलर दि सूत्र रुदूषण पुरुदंसो अनेसांच अनंसौ असंबुद्ध विल गिव अनंग आदेश सो विल गेट नृ विल बिकम नन नन प्लस सकार ऑफ सु प्रत्यय सर्वनाम स्थाने चासंबुद्धौ नकार उपधाय विल टेक दीर्घ इट विल बिकम नन विल बिकम नान नान प्लस सकार देन हल्याभ्यो दीर्घा सुधिस प्रयुक्त हल लुप्यते आफ्टर दिस नकार विच इज हल सु दिस सु विच इज सकार हल टेक्स लोप गोज अवे सो विल हैव नान विच इज अगेन वॉट नलोप प्रातिपदिकांतस्य पदस्य पदांत नकार एंड ऑल्सो इट इज ऑल्सो प्रातिपदिकांत नकार देर फोर इट विल गो अवे एंड विल गेट ना Na is the first case singular form. Then nru plus au. What will happen? Ruto ni sarvanam sthane angasya guna will apply. You will get narau. So na narau naraha naha. This is sambodhana. Naram narau nrun. So in this sarvanam sthana you will get na. We have derived na. Narau we have derived. Similarly, this aspratya will also give the similar form naraha. Similar sutras will apply. And then ऋतो नी सर्वनाम स्थानयो इन दि सर्वनाम स्थान यू विल गेट ना नरौ नरः नरम नरौ दिस इज दि रूप सिद्धि फॉर दोज देन पर्टिकुलर सूत्र इज नीडेड फॉर दि षष्ठी बहुवचन एवरीथिंग एल्स विल डिक्लाइन सिमिलर टू व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड नो मोर सूत्रास आर नीडेड बट इन षष्ठी बहुवचन नृ टेक्स अ डिफरेंट फॉर्म नृच सूत्र इज नृच नामी दीर्घ उभयता सो व्हाट डज इट से इज दैट उभयता मीन्स ऑप्शनली Again, this means va ubhayata. Both ways it is possible, meaning there can be optional dirgha. Optional dirgha. So nru can rukara can take dirgha optionally when naam follows. So naam is what this nudagama has come in. So nru plus am praswanadhyapo nut nudagama has come in. Adyanto takito will apply, and then you will get this. This am pratya adi will take this nakara agama, so it will become naam. So nru plus am shashti bahuvachana will become nru plus naam. Now nami what? Nami nrucha says what? Angasya dirgha ubhayata. What has been said here? Nami is there. This nami is missed here. Angasya nami. उभयता नामी. नामी दीर्घा इज ऑप्शनल, उभयता मीन्स दीर्घा इज ऑप्शनल, सो इट कैन बिकम नृणाम और इट कैन बिकम नृणाम. सो वन फॉर्म इज दिस नृणाम और अनदर इज नृणाम, बोथ आर. सो इफ यू गो बैक एंड सी द चार्ट, यू हैव टू स्क्रोल बैक. सो दिस नामी नृच, नामी दीर्घ विल गिव यू नृणाम, नृणाम एंड देन नृणाम विदाउट द ऑप्शन. सो दिस इज द विभाषा, उभयता मीन्स विभाषा. यू कैन गेट ह्रस्व नृणाम ऑल्सो एंड नृणाम एज दीर्घ ऑल्सो. दिस इज द ओनली एक्सेप्शन हियर, एवरीथिंग एल्स इज एज वी स्टडी इन द धाता इत्यादि, धातृशब्द एंड पितृशब्द ऑल्सो. सो नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड, गो शब्द इज टेकन इनटू कंसिडरेशन. गो कैन मीन काउ ऑल्सो, गो कैन मीन बुल ऑल्सो. सो इन पुल्लिंग इट विल बी वॉट, इट विल मीन बुल, गो शब्द. सो ओकारांत पुल्लिंग शब्द, वॉट हैपन्स हियर, इट इज एन अतिदेश सूत्र. गोतो नित सर्वनाम स्थानम, सूत्र सेज गोतो नित. नाउ दिस इज इंटरप्रिटेड डिफरेंटली, दिस शब्द गोतः इज इंटरप्रिटेड डिफरेंटली बाय डिफरेंट वृत्तिस. लघु टेक्स इट इन वन वे, काशिका टेक्स इट इन अनदर वे. बोथ मेंशन, आई मीन एटलीस्ट काशिका मेंशंस एज टू सम कंसिडर दिस एज ओतः नित. They read this sutra not as goto nit but oto nit. So if you look at this gotah nit, vartika is oto nit iti vachyam. So vartikakara says this goto nit is not necessary, oto nit should have been said in the sutra. So what does it mean? He said nidvat, it becomes as though nit. Consider this go shabda in sarvanama sthana is considered as what? As actually not go shabda, but after the go shabda, the sarvanamasthana pratyas, they are treated as nit. Sarvanamasthana are the first five sut anapunsakasya. So they are considered as though there is a nakara which is an it letter. What will it mean? It can cause vriddhi. But then it is for go shabda here. However, some read this as taparakarana, this oath, oataha nit. So this taparakarana cannot be applied to go shabda. So they say it is a taparakarana, and if it is taparakarana, then taparakarana is for okara, it can be for a single letter. Like vriddhir adaich, at, at is a taparakarana of akara. Or where you look at this adengunaha, at, at is taparakarana of akara. So only a letter, akshara, a vowel takes taparakarana. You cannot have taparakarana for where there is no matra for an entire shabda. So go shabda has okara which can take taparakarana, but go shabda itself cannot take taparakarana. Therefore some interpret this as taparakarana and thereby gotonit. Otherwise it can also be what? It can be panchami ekvachana of go. So tasil anta shabda can also be there, gotaha. So after this go shabda, after go shabda, whichever sarvanam sthana pratyay is added, that should be seen as nit. This is what the simple kashika vritti says that. And laghukara says okara, considering what? Considering the taparakarana as per the vartika. So they, due to vartika, he says okarat vihitam sarvanam sthanam nidvat syat. It is as though nit, deemed to be nit. So what will happen is that you look at this go shabda, go plus su, what will happen? This go shabda, this su pratyaya sarvanama sthana, sarvanama sthana, sarvanama sthana pratyaya, the first five sut, sut will be sarvanama sthanam, and thereby this su is sarvanama sthana. What will happen? Goto nit will apply, sarvanama sthanam is nitvat, nitvat. Then what will happen? This acho nitti vriddhi, it can cause vriddhi. Nitvat, so nit, this pratyaya is, this su pratyaya is considered as nit pratyaya. If it is nit pratyaya, then it can cause vriddhi. Anga will take vriddhi, okara will become aukara. Alontyasya sthanantaratamaha will apply, and then aukara is the adesha, go will become gau. Then sakara by rutto visarga, this will give you sasavishom ru 8266 and 8315 kharavasane or visarjaniya. So gau hu is the prathama ekavachana rupasiddhi. Then when the dvivachana pratyay is added, go plus au, what will happen there? Go to nit again, Aukara go will achuniti vriddhi nidvat and then achuniti vriddhi will give you gau. Gau plus au, what like HOA will apply. Gau plus au, au will become av. Au will become av, then gavau. Varnamilana will gavau. So you will get gauhu, gavau and gavaha. So the first three are done by us. Jas also is what? Basically jakara will go away, us. Prathama bahuvachana will be go plus us. And nidvat, because sarvanamasthana. So you will get gau plus us. Gau plus us, HOA will apply. You will get gav plus us. Rutva visarga, gavaha. You will get gavaha. Gauhu, gavau, gavaha. Then when you add second case singular, what will happen? The next sutra is introduced as a vidhi sutra for that purpose. Auto amshasoho is a otaha amshasoho. That is a padacheda. A is hidden in out. Autaha. Achi purva parayoho ekaha samitam. So ek adesha, what is the adesha? When achi, ajadi pratyaya follows, which pratyaya? Or shas? Is second case singular and shas is what? So I'll bracket this. It is not the case here. The case is shashti divachana. Shashti amshasoho shashti divachana. But within that, what is second case singular pratya and shas is what? Second case plural pratya. So in these two cases, that is shashti bhavachana, what will happen? A is the adesha, autaha. Autaha means a otaha. A is the adesha. A otaha will become autaha by sandhi. So autaha here is what? Autaha is panchami ekvachana. And before that a is there. So otaha is panchami ekvachana, a is prathama ekvachana. So a otaha amshasoho achi pare puro pareho eka adesha. Samhitayam vishe, what is the adesha? A iti adesha. Which will take adesha? And shas will take adesha. Shas is also what? Ajadi pratyaya. Is ajadi pratyaya. So achi, ajadi pratyaya pare. Which pratyaya? Particularly and shas. Meaning the ach of or shas. The vowel which is at the beginning of or shas pratyaya will take a adesha. Puro parayo. Not only that, the earlier also will take the adesha. Puro parayo ekaha. So okara and the vowel which follows in the and shas pratyaya, both together will be replaced by a single adesha. So now we have go plus second case singular. So okara and a both together will be replaced by akara, single akara. This autom shasoho. So what will get gam? This is done, second case singular. That's all. Varnam yelana, you get gam. In the shasthana also same sutra will apply. Okara and shakara gozavi will ashakvat taddite tasse lopaha. So both together O and akara of shas will be replaced by a single adesha. So you'll get gas. Gas then rutto visarga will you give you gaha. So you got gauhu, gavau, gavaha, gam, gavau, gaha. Second case dual is same. Gaha. This is second case plural. Rupa siddhi. Then HOYAVAYAVA all the way, you will get GO plus TA, GAVA. OKARA plus A will give you HOYAVA. OKARA will become AU by HOYAVAYA, GO will become GAU. Then VARNAMENALA GAVA. TRITIYA EKVACHANA. Then GOBHYAM, GOBHI, nothing else to be done there. Then all the AJADI STANA you will get HOYAVAYA. Meaning wherever there is a vowel, HOYAVA will apply and you will get GAVE. Gava, Gave. Here, this form is a copy paste. Gave, it should be Gave. So, Gave, it should be. There are a lot of copy paste errors in this book. So, Gava, this has been copy pasted here. Gave. Then, Nyasi. Here also, what? Goho. This is Panchami, Ekvachana, Shashti Ekvachana also. Goho. Nyasi, Nyasoscha. Engaha, Ati. Purvaha ekaha purva parayo. Here we expect HOYAVAYA to apply, but there is a specific sutra as to gnyasi gnyasoscha ati. When akara of gnyas or as gnyasi or gnyas follows, then what will happen? Engaha, okara is eng, after an eng, purva paray ekadesha. So the okara and this a both together are replaced by the purva okara. This okara itself is the adesha. This fellow is the adesha here for both together. Then what will happen? Rutto visarga goho. So there is a difference. Here there is an okara goho. Here goho and here also goho. Ditto. Then so this is an exception to the vowel, the ajadi pratyaya. Elsewhere ajadi pratyaya hoy will apply. 6170 days hoy, here also hoy. So what will happen? Gavoho, here also hoy, am pratyaya gavam gavi, here also gavoho. There is nothing else to be done there. And in any way, in bhyam bhihi bhyaha and sustana, nothing to be done here specifically. This adesha pratyaya sutra will apply. The sakara, which is apadanta sakara, will take murdhanya adesha. It will become goshu. Why this word is important? Because in Vedanta especially, you will hear go shabda used a lot. Not in Vedanta itself, but in Tarka Shastra also. If you study Tarka more, then for all the lakshanas, for example, gotva lakshana, go lakshana is given. What is kim nama gotvam? So then to explain the all the ativyapti, avyapti and asambho dosha, go example is used. And to use go, we have to know how it is declined. And this is an example used over and over in Vedanta Shastra also, especially when you study further in Brihat Granthas or Prasthanatraya or Tikas. So you'll see go shabda, it is important for that reason. Otherwise, you know, difficult to see, remember these forms, okara ending, pullinga also and strilinga also. Fortunately, in strilinga and pullinga, both have a same declension. This go shabda has a same declension. There is nothing else to be seen in strilinga as different. So the cow and bull decline in a same manner. Now rai shabda, aikaranta, aikar after okara, aikara, aikara ending words. Example here is rai. Rai is wealth, dhana. How does it decline? Thankfully, again in masculine and feminine, it declines in the same manner. Rayohali sutra, vidhi sutra introduces rayohali a vibhakto. Akara is the adesha. When a haladi vibhakti follows, which shabda? Rai shabda. So that will take what? Rayaha shashti. Here itself the shashti rupa is seen, rayaha. So shashti is siddha by sutra itself. So rai shabda followed by a haladi vibhakti takes an a adesha. So aikara will become akara. So what will you get? Very simple actually. Whenever a haladi pratyaya follows, meaning which pratyaya? Su pratyaya in the first case singular, su pratyaya in the seventh case plural, then you have all these bhakaradi forms. Which are the forms? Those bhis pratyaya, bhyas pratyaya, bhyam pratyas, three bhyams and two bhyas pratyas, one bhis pratyaya. And two su, one is the prathama ekvachana su and the last one is supratya. All these are haladi pratyas. So haladi vibhakti pare what will happen? Rai will become ra. So rai aikara is replaced by akara. So rai will be heard as ra. So you will get what? Rabihi, rabhyam ityadi. So first case singular, we look at what happens here. Rai aikara has been replaced by akara. So ai becomes, sorry, not I, has become akara. So you get rai became ra. So ras will become what? Raha. That's all. First case singular, because sakara rutto visarga sasojushoru, then kharavasani or visarjane, raha, first case singular. Now interestingly, only the which pratyas, the pratyas which are beginning with hal, meaning haladi pratyas, will cause this rai to become ra. What happens in ajadi pratyasthana? In ajadi pratyasthanas, hoy will apply. If hoy applies, what happens to aikara? Aikara followed by ajadi pratyaya, sandhi will take place, hoy will cause ra. Ra, rai will become ra. And what is actually rai? It will become rai. So there also you will hear ra, but followed by yakara. So wherever there is a haladi pratyaya, you will not hear yakara, but ra will be heard. And whenever you have a vowel ending, vowel pratyaya beginning with a vowel, there you will have ra, but with a yakara. So if you look at the form, hoy is applying, that's all rai. Now if you go to the table proper, you will see what? Raha. Here we saw raha. Again here ra, but with a yakara. So if you look at it, all the ajadi pratyasthanas you hear yakara after what? After ra. And wherever you have, these are all ajadi, ajadisthanas, except for the first case singular, because it is not ajadisthana, it is what? Haladisthana. So there you hear only ra, not rai. Elsewhere you will hear rai because I is the hoiya krita I. So you will get what? You will get ra all over, and you will hear yakara before the pratyaya whenever a vowel beginning pratyaya sthana is there. Wherever there is a haladi pratyaya, there you will hear ra only. So it is very simple. Otherwise, raha rayau rayaha, rayam rayau rayaha, then raya rabhyam rabhihi, no yakara, that's all. Raye ya yakara because ajadi. Raye rabhyam rabhyaha, rayaha rabhyam rabhyaha, then rayaha rayoho rayam, rai rayoho rasu. Here there is no yakara. Everywhere else when there is a ajadi pratyaya, you will hear ra with a yakara, raya, rai. So otherwise it is simple. If you understand this, what is exactly happening, rai has never heard in rai form at all. Rai becomes ra in both cases. Whenever haladi is there, there is a particular sutra which says akara as the adesha. This sutra, our current sutra, rayo hali, rayaha, rai shabda will take a adesha. Ai will become a. And in non-haladi sthana, hoiya will cause rai to become rai by I becoming I. So you will have Rai there. And then just Varna Milana or whatever Sandhi takes place, you just do that. There is no Sandhi between Yakara and any Ajadi Pratya. Therefore, there will only Varna Milana. And with Hal also, since you have Akara preceding, between Akara, preceding Akara. So you look at the funny scenario. Whenever there is a Haladi Pratya, what will happen? Haladi Pratya is there. Then you will have a situation of Haladi Pratya will have caused the Adesha Rai to become Ra. Ai has taken Adesha, Rai will become A. So this Akara and Haladi, vowel and consonant can have only Varna Milana. There is no Sandhi there possible between these. And in Ajadisthana, what is happening? In Ajadisthana, Ajadi Pratya, their Rai with HOI will become Rai. So Yakara, Hal is beginning. Between Hal and vowel now. Earlier between vowel and hal, hala, there cannot be any. Ach and hal cannot have any sandhi varna milana. And here yakara is hal. Between hal and ajadi pratyaya vowel, between hal and ach, there cannot be any sandhi there varna milana. So there is nothing else to do. Just chant them together. That's all. If you understand this single sutra and HOIYA, Rutva Visarga, I am assuming anyway it is known. Rai Shabda is really easy. Aikara seems very difficult, but then it has to be, form-wise, it has to be very easy. Okay, then glove. After I, aukara. Aukara and so glove here, how it is derived is shown. Glayati iti glove. So glayati means where there is glana. Glani bhavati bharata, we know from dharma glani from Bhagavad Gita. So glani is meaning depletion. Depletion of what? Their dharma. Dharmasya glani hi bhavati. Here the size of Chandra is becoming less. So what becomes less across a fortnight, Chandra is losing the size, is changing size. From Purnima to Amavasya, the size is diminishing. Therefore, Glayati iti glau. So moon, the word Chandra is derived, not the word Chandra, glau. Glau stands for Chandra by Vyutpatyartha. Glayati iti glau, that which declines across paksha, it declines. Of course, across the other paksha, it grows. But then we see a moon is cylindrical. So the shape of the moon is not growing. It is only diminishing. It remains same or it diminishes and diminishes lesser and lesser in the Shukla Paksha. In Krishna Paksha, it diminishes more and more. In both cases, there is Glani, therefore Glayati iti glau, and thereby you get this glau shabda. How is it is derived is seen. This pratyaya is added. Ditva Samartya, Dau pratyaya is added by Unadi Sutra. Harshakshe glai, Harshakshe, and then Dau. Dau pratyaya is added. Glanu dibhyam, Dau. So Dau pratyaya is a Dit pratyaya. Ditva Samartya, अवश्यापि टेर लोपा सी टी लोपा टेक्स प्लेस सो ग्लई ऐकार गोज अवे ऐ इज टी इन ग्लई सो ग्लई धातु लूजेस ऐकार बाय टी लोपा बिकॉज द प्रत्यय इज डिथ जनरली डिथ कॉजेस टिलोपा इन भस्य अधिकार भस्य अधिकार यू हैव टेर लोपः टे हे सो टेर लोप टी विल टेक लोप ओनली इफ देर इज अ भ अंग हवेवर इफ डिथ प्रत्यय इज देर देन देर इज अ वार्तिक विच सेज डित्व सामर्थ्यात् अवश्यापि टेर लोपः सो टी लोप इज देर इवन इन दी नॉन भ अंग वाय बिकॉज डित्व प्रत्यय हैज इज डित एंड बिकॉज ऑफ डित्व सामर्थ्य डित्व हैज दैट काइंड ऑफ सामर्थ्य दैट टी लोप टेक्स प्लेस इवन इफ देर इज नो भ अंग प्रिसीडिंग सो देर बाय दिस ग्लव ग्लई विल बिकम ग्लकारा एंड ग्लकारा प्लस औ विल गिव यू ग्लव सो दिस इज द रूप सिद्धि ऑफ विच इज आउटसाइड ऑफ द स्कोप ऑफ लघु एक्चुअली इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द सूत्र सो ग्लव नाउ वॉट हैपन्स हाउ डू यू डिक्लेर दिस औकारांत शब्द दैट इज एक्सप्लेन हियर ग्लव प्लस सू वॉट विल हैपन रुत्व विसर्ग ग्लव हू नथिंग एल्स टू बी डन देर ओनली सकार विल बिकम Repha, Ru and then Visarga. So first case singular is done. Then H-O-A-Y-A-V-A, all the place H-O-A-Y-A-V-A will give you what? Glavo, Glavaha. Nothing else to be done there. Like Rai Shabda, similarly only Rai Aikara became I, here Aukara will become Av. So you will get Glauhu, Glavo, Glavaha, Glavam, Glavo, Glavaha, Glava, Glaubhyam. Here nothing to be done. Glaubhyam, Ityadi. Nothing else to be done. Either H-O-A-Y-A-V-A, where there is Ajadi Pratya or Varna Melana in other sthanas. Of course, in Suhustana, we saw Rutto Visarga applying. So, gloves will become, then Rutto Visarga, Sandhi Sutras and other Sutras will apply. Iti Ajanta Pullinga. So, we have done a recap of Ajanta Pullinga Shabda. Now, we'll go to Strilinga Shabda. Atha Ajanta Strilinga. Stock example is Rama Shabda. Thankfully, the same Shabda here as we otherwise study. So, Rama Shabda. How does Rama Shabda get its vyutpatti? So, that is explained here that it is a Tabanta Shabda. Tabanta Shabda, Strilinga, A Pratyaya is added, which is actually Tap. Ajadyatash Tap will apply there. After what Ramu Kridayam Dhatu Ramate Vishnuna Sakam Iti Rama. One who rejoices with Vishnu is called as Rama, meaning Lakshmi. Rama means Lakshmi. सो रमु क्रीडायां प्लस अच नंदी ग्रही पचादिभ्यो ल्युणि ल्युणी निच सो ल्युणी न्यच देर बाय वॉट विल हैपन हियर यू विल गेट रम रम धातु प्लस अच अ चकार इज इट लेटर अ सो रम प्लस अ इज रम रम देन अजाद्यतष्टा दी वोवेल एंडिंग वर्ड हियर विल गेट टाप प्रत्यय पकार विल गो वे टकार विल गो वे आ इज द कंटेंट रमा सो दिस इज यू गेट हाउ यू गेट अकस्वर्णी दीर्घ विल गिव रम प्लस आ विल गिव रमा रमा शब्द मीन्स लक्ष्मी हाउ डज इट डिक्लाइन नाउ सो रमा प्लस सु हियर हल्याभ्यो दीर्घात विल अप्लाई हियर नॉट हल बट दीर्घात आफ्टर अ दीर्घ नॉट अ दीर्घ ऑल्सो हियर सॉरी हल्याभ्यो आबंत आप इज हिडन हियर सो टाप इज ऑल्सो आप आबंत टाबंत हिज टाप प्रत्यय इज वॉट दिस टाप अजाद्यत स्टाप दिस स्टाप हैज अप्लाइड द स्टाप इज आप टकार विल गो आप सो आबंत टाप छाप डाप ऑल आर और आबंत सो वॉट विल हैपन हनी आभ्यो आप आफ्टर एन आबंत रमा इज एन आबंत शब्द देर बाय वॉट विल हैपन सू दिस सू नॉट टी एंड सी सू सू विच इज अप्रुक्त सिंगल लेटर उकार विल गो ए सकार विच इज अप्रुक्तम एकाल प्रत्यय हल इट इज हल लुप्यते लोपः सो लोप इज अनुवृत्ति हियर लोपः लोप मीन्स लुप्यते हल लोपः और हल लुप्यते देर बाय विल गेट रमा फर्स्ट केस सिंगुलर देन इन औ स्थान व्हाट विल हैपन औंग आपः अंगात शी शी इज द आदेश औंग औंगः षष्ठी एकवचन आपः आफ्टर एंड आबंत शब्द प्रातिपदिक औंग औंग मीनिंग औ विच फॉलोज दिस औंग औंग विल टेक वॉट शी आदेश दिस इज औंग कॉल्ड एज औंग So ong, this will take what? Shi adesha. Shakara is an ith letter while ashakat taddite. Ataddita, it is not a taddita. Shakara will take itsanya, tasya lopa, it will go away. So e is the adesha. Au is replaced by e. So Rama shabda here, Rama is an avanta shabda. That avanta shabda, following that, after that avanta shabda, ong will take shi adesha. So what will you get here? Rama plus au, au will be replaced by she, which is e. So Rama plus e, what you will get is ad gunaha. Ad gunaha, after an avarna achi pare, ikara is an ach. Therefore, after an avarna achi pare, you will get guna. So you will get guna adesha, this will take guna. Both ekaha puro pare, both will be replaced by a single guna letter. Sane antartama will give you ekar. So you get rame. Rame is first case singular as well as second case, sorry, first case dual as well as second case dual. Then plural rama plus just is us. What will happen? Prathamayoho purva savarna, which you already studied, that is prapta, but dirgha jasi cha na, this will not apply. Then it will go back to akas savarne dirgha. Akas savarne dirgha, which is prapta, was negated by prathamayoho purva savarna, which is further negated by dirgha jasi cha, because it is not just it is a jasthana. So in jasthana, prathamayoho purva savarna will not apply. Prathamayoho purva savarna applies for the first two vibhaktis, but jasi cha, dirgha jasi cha na, prathamayoho purva savarna na bhavati. Some cases guna is prapta, here dirgha is prapta. So earlier we had seen dirgha jasi cha, guna I had mentioned earlier, guna is not the adesha there. Guna is prapta by refuting what is prapta. So prathamayo purva savarna dirgha was prapta, that purva savarna dirgha is negated by dirgha jasi cha. Then whatever is prapta there is, what was prapta earlier, which was negated by prathama purva savarna, will come back and place itself. So therefore, earlier in some cases there can be guna also. Here it is akas savarne dirgha. Dirgha is applicable and you will get rama plus a plus as. A plus a will become a single akara, which is a dirgha adesha, and then ramas rutto visarga will give ramaha. So rama rame ramaha. This is first case plural. In fact, the same thing will apply to second case plural also. Sambuddhaucha एत आपह अंगस्य विधि सूत्र इन संबुद्धि व्हाट विल हैपन अंग हियर इज रमा इट इज एन आबंत अंग एंड संबुद्धौच व्हेन संबुद्धि प्रत्यय फॉलोस संबुद्धि इज व्हाट संबोधन प्रथम सो संबोधन प्रथम इन एकवचन दैट इज संबुद्धि व्हाट इज द आदेश एत इज द आदेश तपरकरण हैज बीन डन एकार इत्यर्थ एकार इज द आदेश एकार Adesha will apply to the Anga. So, Akara will be replaced by Ekara. Rama will become Rame. So, last one, the Akara will take Adesha. Alontyasya. So, Apaha here is Apaha Shashti Ekvachana Angasya. Abantasya Angasya Ityartha. Tadanta Vidhi will apply. Abanta Anga will take Ekara. Rama is Abanta will take Ekara. Will become Rame when in Sambuddhi. So, it will become Rame. Nothing else to be done there. So Rama plus Su in Sambodhana Prathama will become Rame plus Sakara. Halnya Abhyo Dirga Sudhisya Pryuktam Hal is applicable, but then Sambuddha Ucha is an Apovada, and thereby Apovada and also what? Para. Para meaning some Paribhasha Sutra will apply there. And thereby the later sutra can apply. That's one kind of padachheda there. Eng hraswat sambuddhehe lopaha, that will apply here. Eng hraswat, after an ekara, hraswat sambuddhehe lopa. Rame is already siddha, but sakara has to go away here. This sakara will go away. Eng hraswat sambuddhehe lopa, and then halnyabhyo, this would have attained, but there is a particular sutra. Eng hraswat sambuddhehe, in sambuddhi lopa is by this sutra 6169, not 6168. The result is the same. The result is the same. Rame. You will get Rame in Sambodhana. So, He Rame. He Ramaha. He Rame in Dvivachana is already known. First case dual and Sambodhana dual is same. So this is what this is. Sambodhana Prathama. First case Sambodhana Prathama. Rama Rame Ramaha. He Rame. He Rame. He Rame. This is Dvivachana. Then He Ramaha. So this He Rame here is twice, because one is Sambuddhi. Sambodhana Prathama Ekvachana. Here is Sambodhana Prathama Dvivachana. Then He Ramaha is Sambodhana Bahuvachana, which is same as the Prathama Bahuvachana. Ramam Rame Ramaha. So here is the second case plural. Shas is also same as what we already derived here. So this is second case plural also. Nothing more to be done there. Same sutras apply. Further, what Tasthana? Ta is called as Ang. So Angi. Angi Chapaha Angasya Et Osi. So now in this sutra will cover three forms. Osi Pratya. Osi is a Shashti Dvivachana and Saptami Dvivachana. Bracketed because I am talking about the Pratya. But this Osi is what? Saptami Ekvachana form is Osi. Os Pratya is Shashti, is the Vibhakti in Shashti Dvivachana and Saptami Dvivachana. That's why I bracketed it. Eth is the Adesha. So this Shashti Saptami Ekvachana, I'd rather go here. Saptami Ekvachana is the form of this particular Os in Saptami Ekvachana. Os is Shashti or Saptami Dvivachana Pratyaya. Osi Pare Eth Adesha Bhavati. Kasya Angasya Avantasya Chapaha. Avantasya Angasya. Rama is an Avantanga. So when Os or Ta is what? Angi. Ang is the old Sanya for Ta. So when Ang follows, then what will happen? Or Os follows. Os will be. So this is what? Third case singular, sixth case dual, or seventh case dual. What will be the Adesha? A will be replaced by A. So Rama will become Rame. So what will happen in third case singular? Rame. Pratyaya is A. So what will get? Rame plus A. HOIO will apply. You will get Ramay plus A. Ramaya. In Osisthana, what will happen? Same. Os will cause HOIOI, will get Ramay plus O, Ramayoho. Rutto Visargal, Ramayoho. So Ramaya, then Ramayoho, Ramayoho. This is the Rupa Siddhi for third case singular, sixth and seventh case dual. Together you can see with the same sutra. There you can see here, Ta Pratya is Ang, Angi cha Apaha, A will be the, this Ta is A, and will cause Rama Akara. So not, this is not the Adesha here. Here Akara has become Ekara. So Akara becomes Ekara. A is replaced by A. By this eighth Adesha. Eighth is the Adesha. And OC Pare also same thing will happen. Then HOI will apply in both cases. Ramai will be the Anga here also. Third case singular. In sixth case dual and plural also it will be like that. Sixth case dual and seventh case dual. Os Pratyaya will follow and cause HOIY. Rame will become Ramay. Ekara, first Rama will become Ekara in Shashti Dvivachana and Saptami Dvivachana also, along with third case singular. Then Ramay by HOIY. Here there is an A Pratyaya, you will get Ramaya. In sixth case and seventh case dual, you will get Ramayos. Then Rutta Visarga Ramayoho. In the Ramabhyam Ramabhi, this Bhis and Bhyas, Bhyam Stana, just Varnamilana, nothing else to be done there. Now what happens in Nitsthana? In Nitsthana, additional sutras will apply. So that sutra is into Vidhi Sutra. Yad Apaha Angat Nitaha. So Yat is the Agama. Yat is an Agama which will apply to Nit Pratya. After which Angat, Avantat Angat, Apaha Angat. When Nitaha, Nit Pratya will take what? Nit Pratya becomes Thani, that will take Yat Agama. After an Avanta, so Rama is an Avanta. So after Avanta in Nitsthana, which is that Nitsthana? Chaturthi Ekvachana, Panchami Ekvachana, Shashti Ekvachana, Saptami Ekvachana. These are all Nitsthanas. So all the Nitsthanas, Nitpratyas will take Yad Agama. And Adyanta Takito will apply. So Adi, Tith will go to Adi of Nitpratya. So Gne will become what? Gne will become Ya. Ya will go there and Ya plus. So in fourth case singular, you will have Ya plus A, Nye Pratya. then fifth case singular and sixth case singular, what will you get? Both together you will get ya plus us. Nyasi and nyas both will get ya plus us. In saptami ekvachana what will happen? Ni pratyaya is there. So ya plus e. E is the content ni pratyaya. So this is what will happen. And then ya plus a, ya plus us, ya plus e. What do we expect? That we'll see. So here you look at rama plus ne, chaturthi ekvachana, yat plus a. Now here vriddhi rechi will apply. Because ekara is following what? Akara. So akara and ekara will invoke this vriddhi rechi at samhitayam. After an a, vriddhi hi, echi pare, when a follows, then there will be a vriddhi. So what will happen? Ya akara and ekara put together, there will be a, will cause vriddhi and you will get ramayai. Ramayai, samhitayam vishaya ramayai. So vriddhi is the adesha here. Ramaya plus I will become ramayai. So this is the vriddhi here, this chaturthi ekvachana, ramayai. Varnamilana elsewhere, ramabhyam, ramabhya. Here what happens? Here ramay, yeah, ramay plus us is there. So what happens there? You look at it. Rama plus nyasi, nyitstana. So nyitaha, nyit pratyaya will take ya. So ya plus us. Ya plus us, what will happen in panchami and shashti? Ekvachana, both places what will happen? Akas savarni dirgha will apply. And rama yaha. Why? Rutva visarga. Rutva visarga, rama yaha. Panchami and shashti ekvachana. Then os, anyway we have derived ramayoho. Rutva visarga only after angasya eth adesha, then echo ayava, which we already derived earlier with tritiya. So ramayoho in both cases. Ramanam, what happens here? Nami dirga. Hraswanadhyapo nudagama will come in. Adyanto takito, am will become nam, then nami dirgaha. Dirga here, akara is already dirga. Akara will take dirga parjanyavatu. The rain will fall even if the ground is wet. There also the rain will fall parjanyavatu. So rama akara will take dirgha, akara will remain akara. Even if it is replaced by akara, you don't see a difference. Nami dirgha, then atkupvangnu vyavayapi nakarasya natvam. So you will get ramanam shashti bahuvachana. Nistana again, yadagama. So what will happen here? First before that nistana. Here we expect this ikara, ya plus ikara, but what happens here is nyehe am nadyam nibhya. That sutra we have already seen earlier with the nadi shabda. So here what happens? Ikara is replaced by am. Nyehe, ni not ikara, ni pratya is replaced by am. So this is sthani, this is ni is replaced by am. Nadyam nibhya. So what happens here is that this nadi sanya will give you am, ni will take am adesha and you will get rama plus ya plus am, akasavarne dirgha, ya plus am will become yam, then rama plus yam is varna melana will give you saptami ekvachana in feminine rama yam. Tamasu again varna melana, ramayo we already derived. Nothing else to be done here. Similarly, what? Evam Durga Ambika Adaya. Durga Shabda, Ambika Shabda, all will decline like Rama Shabda. And then others also are mentioned by the author here. Vidya, Maya, Ganga, Icha. This is Icha. Icha. Ekata, Krupa, Ashanka, Chinta, Jinyasu, Gruha, Devata, Nidra, Nishtha, Bhasha, Ityadi. So that is the Rama Akaranta Strilinga Shabda. Now we go to Sarva Shabda. What is Sarva Shabda? It is Sarvanama. So we will go to Sarvanama and then we look at some which will get optional Sarvanama Sanya. Thereby some have Rama like forms and Sarva like forms. So first we have to see what are the forms of Sarvanama Shabda Sarva, which is Akaranta Abanta. So Sarva plus Tap, you'll get Sarva. Sarvanama Sanya by Sarvadini Sarvanamani, which we have seen in Pullinga. So same will apply, whatever applied for Sarva Shabda for Pullinga, it will apply for Sarva also in Strilinga. The difference is that in Sarva Shabda, different from Akaranta Rama Shabda, what is the difference? There we saw in Pullinga the difference is at 5 places. Here there is a difference in four places from Strilinga, Rama Shabda, Sarva Shabda. What happens is that these are the four sthanas, but we'll look at it after the sutra or through the sutra. Sarvanamna syad rasvascha apaha gnitaha. Vidhi sutra said Sarvanama Shabda takes syat agama. Syat is the agama. Syat is the agama. Sarvanama abantadu. It is an apaha. Apaha gnitaha. After an abanta shabda, strilinga pratipadika, the nit pratyas will take syad agama. Which are the nit pratyas? All these four sthanas where there is a difference. Actually, not four, five. This is not included here. I mentioned four places, four pratyas basically, but five places. In pulling also five places, in strilinga also five places, there is a difference. The places are different. Meaning where in pullinga there is a differentiation between sarvanama and non-sarvanamasthana and not sarvanamasthana, sarvanama. How a sarvanama declines in pullinga and how a non-sarvanama declines, non-pronoun, meaning noun and a pronoun. What is the difference in pullinga? Five places. Those five places are different from how the five places differ in strilinga, akaranta, between noun and pronoun. So between noun and pronoun in pullinga and strilinga, both have five different forms, but five places where they are different are not the same between pullinga and strilinga. I hope there is no confusion, it is clear. So in pullinga there was this prathama bahuvachana different, etc., fourth case singular. But here prathama bahuvachana is same as the noun, pronoun does not differ in strilinga. So sarvasyai in this is nistana. These four, 1, 2, 3, and 4, these are nistana, nitstana, not nistana, nitstana. These are all nit pratyas. And this is shashti bahuvachana. In shashti bahuvachana also there is a difference. So four of this and one of this shashti bahuvachana will give five sthanas where there is a difference. What is the difference? Syad agama takes place in nit sthana. In the fourth, fifth, and sixth and seventh case singulars there is. So this is fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh case singular. There, nit pratyaya takes syad agama, and adyantau takitau will work there and cause this sya takara is it halantyam tasya lopa syat will sya. So sya agama, sya will go to the beginning of the pratyaya. So we'll get what? Sya plus a in fourth case singular. So we look at that in the derivation. So sarva plus ni ekara, before that there's a syad agama by adyantu takitau, and this takara will go away. You will have sya. And what is another adesha? If you look at it, this is not the only adesha. Syad agama is to the pratyaya, but there is another adesha. This I miss. Hraswascha. Hraswascha is a hraswa is also an adesha. So syad is an agama and hraswa is the adesha. Syad agama will go to the pratyaya. Which pratyaya? Nit pratyaya. And hraswa will go to the anga. Which anga? Abanta anga. Abanta, apa is there, therefore after an abanta anga where there is sarvanama. So sarvanama abanta anga. So that will take hraswa. So aap will basically sarvanama which ends with an aap, that abanta aap will take hraswa, meaning the aap of the sarvanama strilinga shabda will take hraswa, meaning syat will follow, but there will be a hraswa adesha also. After the sarva akara will become hraswa. So akara takes hraswa and will become akara. So sarva will become sarva. And syat agama to the pratyaya. First you have to resolve this syat plus a. What will happen here? Vriddhirechi. So vriddhirechi will apply and sya akara plus ekara will become aikara. So syai, you will get syai. Sarva has become sarva, so sarva syai. This is what? Chaturthi ekvachana. Similarly, sarva plus nyasi, sarva syaha. How? Again, syat plus as, here akas savarne dirga will give you syas, rutva visarga will give you sarva syaha. Hraswa is anyway, sarva has become sarva, same as earlier, sarva will become sarva by hraswascha. Syat and hraswa adesha will go together. Syat agama to the pratyaya and hraswa adesha for the anga. Sarva will become sarva and us will become sya plus us. So syas akasavarni dirgha sarvasyas, and then rutva visarga will use sarvasyaha. This is panchami and shashti ekvachana. Then sarvasam is in the shashti bhavachana sthana. What will happen? Sarva plus am. Here what? Ami sarvanamna sut. When an am pratyaya follows shashti bhavachana, am pratyaya follows, it will take sudagama. Sut is what? Again tit adyante utakito. It will go to the sakara. Sut is takara is in it, ukara is in it. Sakara is the agama there. Sakara will go to the beginning of am. It will become sam. So you will get sarva plus sam, sarvasam. Varanamirana will give saptami ekvachana sarvasam. Nisthana, again we come back to saptami ekvachana, which is sarvasam. Sarvasam is shashti bahuvachana. Then you go to saptami ekvachana, which is again ni pratyaya. This is saptami ekvachana. This is the rupa siddhi, it has not been given there. Sarvasam is the form. Again dirgha here is nami dirgha, not akasavarni dirgha, nami dirgha. Particularly there is a sutra nami dirgha, so you will get sarva plus sam. There is no this sarva Ami Sarvanamna Sut, A is already there, Sarva Akara is already Dirga, but Parjanyavat, as I mentioned, Parjanyavat, you have to apply because Sutra is there. Otherwise, what happens elsewhere where Dirga is not already there, we may forget. Therefore, you have to apply Parjanyavat. Okay, coming to Saptami Ekvachana, I'll stop after this. What happens? Sarva plus Ni. Here, Nir Amnaha, Nir Am Nadyam Nibhyaha. So, here what will happen? Am will be the Adesha. Ni will be replaced by am, then sarva plus am. Here sarvanamna syad harsva chavai nitsthana. Nitsthana again am, although am is a replacement for ni, pratyaya here there is no pratyaya lope, but pratyaya lakshana is maintained. This ni being replaced by am will not lose its nitvam. Nitva is still there. Thereby what will happen? Sarva syat will be prapta. And harasva also. Sarva will become sarva and sya will be the adesha. Both together. That's why it is used twice. Twice to store two steps. One is the first step is here what? This first step is syat and then second step is harasva. In this step, harasva. But you can do it together also. It can be written as a single form sarva plus syat plus am. Here akasavarni dirgha, thereby sarva, because the earlier this thing what, there was a nami dirgha here, nami dirgha, parjanyavat. This is a little questionable to me, I am not sure about this. There is no nam here, sam is there, I don't know why nami is used here. I would use akasavarni dirgha, which is used here, so it was a little confusing. So I will put a question mark here, I am not going through this again. Somebody who is interested can check up as to why nami has been used here. If I remember, I'll check up. Otherwise, we have done this. Go back to the earlier thing. Akasavarni dirgha will apply as it is applying here, and you will get sarvasyam. Sya plus am will give you syam. Form is sarvasyam. This is what saptami ekvachana in feminine. Shesham ramavat. So then other forms, all other forms are like rama. Evam vishwa adaya. Vishwa also, vishwa is a pronoun and abanta. Therefore, that will also decline like sarva shabda. This finishes the particular akaranta rama shabda noun and sarva shabda pronoun. Now we look at some words which are in the next part. We look at the words which are purva, uttara, ityadi, which stand for directions. They are nitya strilinga, they are in strilinga, akaranta, abanta. However, they take sarvanama. Some take sarvanama optionally. Thereby, we'll see some sutras as to sarvanama sanya is a vibhasha. Vibhasha diksamase bahuryo. As a samasa, there is some sarvanama sthana option, etc. There we'll look at those shabdas and then we'll continue with the next sutra in the next part. तावसाने नटराजराजो नना धड़कान्नो पंचवारम उद्धरतु कामस्य न कादु सिद्धान् एतद् विमर्शे शिवसूत्र जालम्
नमस्ते
कल्याण जी ओके
नो नथिंग नो क्वेश्चन
आई विल सी नेक्स्ट पार्ट देन नमस्ते
नमस्ते थैंक यू